Indeed. Welcome back, everyone. This is Eric Malkavian with your Hull City Tigers. Now, as you can see from our new lineup, I've inserted Ndoye as one of our strikers with Nika Jelkovic. I switched up the lineup to a 5-3-2, put Ramirez, my cam, in at center field, inserted Diame on the right wing, and had David Myler in there because I like that formation in our friendly against Leeds, and I also have a friendly against Manchester United that I haven't posted yet, in which we did quite well as well with this same lineup. So we're going to go with this. Okay, so let's take a look at the tables. This is something I always wish people would show more, and I hate it when they don't. So I'm not going to be that guy. So here we have your Hull City Tigers. Currently sitting in 13th with 3 points, which is a lot better than teams that have no points. Of course, our goal differential is rather large due to that catastrophic match against QPR. Gave them quite a goals for advantage. But I guarantee we will be returning that favor in the future. So, with that being shown off, it's time for your Hull City Tigers to take on whomever we are taking on. Okay. Our next match is against Aston Villa. All right, let's go. We received a transfer. You can find the details. Yeah, he's not going anywhere, yo. $11 million. No. You can just say no. No. He's not going anywhere. Going anywhere. Okay, so obviously Tom Huddleston can't be one of my substitutes. So we are going to bring up another center midfielder. And that would be right. Okay, there we go. Taking a look at my lineup here. All right, it's fine. Let's keep those changes. We are ready to play. We'll be wearing our road the ways. I think, sure. That should be pretty easy to see. All right, so so let's check things. Okay, we're good to go.
Welcome to EA Sports live coverage of the Premier League. Today it's Aston Villa against Hull City. Let's go straight off to Villa Park then. Conditions could hardly be better, certainly for spectators at least. Clear blue skies and warm sunshine. Here's your commentary team, Martin Tyler and Alan Smith.
Hi everybody, Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith welcoming you to this big game today. Hull City playing today on the back of a very good home victory in their last match against Stoke City.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good 2-1 victory that, but looking at them, whether they can follow it up with another one, I doubt. I think they might lose here.
Yeah,
one change for Aston Villa. Brad Guzan starts in goal. Ron Vlaar starts alongside Yoris Akure in the heart of the defence. Fabian Delph starts. Player struggling for his best form at the moment. In attack, Libor Kozak starts up top with Christian Benteke. Hull have one change. Alan McGregor plays in goal. Curtis Davis starts with Michael Dawson in central defence. Gaston Ramirez plays with Mohamed Diame in the centre of the pitch. In attack, Nama Ndoye plays up front with Nikica Jelovic. And we're all watching Hull City today.
Many people expecting much of this side. But, you know, they have got a win under the belt. They've got a defeat too. One or two worrying signs during that defeat. Defensively, they are suspect.
And we are ready to get underway.
First half started by Aston Villa. There's some potential in this move. Brilliant opening, in with a chance. Great stop. Aston Villa need to defend this corner.
That's your Hull City Tigers, baby. Of course he has. I knew better.
Fabian Delph.
Bloody hell.
He's being challenged now. Jelovic. Excellent positioning, and the interception is made. Here's the shot. There's still a chance after the save. Oh, trying to get clear, but he's offside.
Oh, bloody hell. No wonder he didn't shoot it.
This could be a chance. Really in the clear now. Well, he has a go.
Freaking hell.
Put it that
just having a look at the replay, whether it did take a bobble. He'll be hoping it did.
Oh, bloody hell.
Fabian Delph. And have it back. It's a very challenging fixture, this, isn't it, for Aston Villa?
Oh, without doubt, I'm sure the manager in that dressing room would have emphasised that. They couldn't afford to be anything less than at full throttle.
It's got to be. They'll get the shot out. It's still in play. And the ball goes out for a goal kick. Some thoughts on Aston Villa with the younger players. That's been a bright spark, really, hasn't it, that they've been able to at least give the opportunity to young players. Other clubs haven't done that.
No, they haven't, and as a result, I think, you know, they've had some prospects come through, the likes of Ashley Westwood and Fabian Delph, who they got from Leeds, I think, is emerging as a good player.
And he shoots. They've still got an opportunity here after the goalkeeper parried it. Hit the post.
Bloody hell!
You got interrupted there, Alan, about Villa and the young players.
I think Paul Lambert quite naturally errs on the side of young, enthusiastic, energetic young players that he can develop and mould. If you have too many in the same side, of course, it's counterproductive.
Enjoy it. He's got space. Here's the chance. Good judgment there to make that interception, clear the ball away. It's a free kick, and that's all it is. The referee is keeping his cards in his pocket.
We're trying, folks, we're trying.
Mohamed Diame. Hey, there's the back heel. Tries his luck. Still a chance after that save. He's into the challenge. Here's the cross. Catching practice for the goalkeeper. Mohamed Diame. And it goes for goal. An offside call just at the moment where they thought they were going to be in to score.
Yeah, fair play to that defence. They were all in touch with each other. It was a good line that they held.
Oh, boy.
Mohamed Diame. Jelovic. Let's pop over to Alan McInerney. He might be through. What a good piece of defensive clearance that was.
Couldn't get the ball on my foot.
David Myler.
Oh.
His team now can move away from
that was a mistake.
Areas. It's a big game involving Manchester City. Alan McInerney is reporting on it for us. I'm sorry I had to cut him short. And that's the first goal of the game, it's 1-0.
God
damn. To get in behind the opposition.
Sorry about that.
Tom Huddleston, we've got a suspension issue with the away team. Their first choice central midfielder is not available today because of that particular problem.
Yeah, and he's a player that can sit in and protect the two centre halves with his experience, so it's a blow for the manager.
They've been saved and now, team by that offside flag.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, and they know
F-bomb.
Would have been a great scoring opportunity for them.
It would have been.
Villa, I mean, the way they're defending. The opposition may be not so pleased with the way they're running.
running offside all the time.
Yeah, it just takes a cool head and a little bit of brains to time the pass and the run, but the opposition can't manage it at the moment.
Oh, boy. Yeah, I was offside. That wasn't who I was passing it to.
Gaston Ramirez. Sinclair.
Come on! Son of a...
Incredible fall. Oh, no flies on this boy. What a save.
Son of a gun, man. What have I got to do? I just got to keep shooting the ball.
Mike Dean blowing the whistle.
He's all right. I mean, all he did is bump him. Son of a gun, man. Because I couldn't pass it. The guy was off, David Myler was offside.
Here's the chance. He might be needed again, the goalkeeper.
Bloody hell. I thought he was going to call him offside. He said, he's probably offside. Looks like he was offside. Ha ha! That's my boy! On the road at Stoke City.
And the keeper's got no chance because he's hitting so hard to his right.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
Woo! Your whole city Tigers, baby. Jelavich with his third goal of the season. All right, let's not get complacent. Oh, bloody hell. Couldn't quite get it to it. Couldn't quite get to the ball. If Diame was just there a moment earlier he would have scored. Carson was denied, you son of a...
What did you make of it, Alan?
Well, I thought he was onside, you know, but he's gone through and tucked it away. But looking at the replay, yes, he had gone a bit early.
I knew he was offside. I was like, I'm not going to celebrate. Because he's offside.
Taking it well under pressure. Jelovic. Gaston Ramirez.
My bad. Darn it.
Daniel Vaz. Mohamed Diame. David Myler. Here's the shot. The shot making the goalkeeper's job pretty routine.
Yeah.
Offside, and the referee's given it.
Oh, bloody hell.
David Myler. Got to be. Very good try. Just off target.
Just wide. Yeah, I think. Yeah, he was just wide. I was just off target.
Scott Sinclair. Jelovic. Mohamed Diame. A bit of a loss of balance there, but he's still upright. Keeps it going well. That's a very easy decision for the assistant there. It's offside, and it shouldn't have been a missed opportunity for this team.
I tried passing Doye.
Piece of play there from the player. Really should have held his run.
Jelovic. In with a chance.
Struck him
Woo!
Sweetly, and he got a little bit of luck, didn't he? But I think he deserved it.
Let's see the replay now.
This your Holstein Tigers, baby.
And here he goes with the tackle.
Shit.
Didn't hesitate, did he, with that challenge? Here's the chance. Off target. Jelovic. Myler. Brilliant team play this, with the passing, the movement off the ball to make the passing possible. Oh, great interception. That has stopped the attack.
Come on, come on. Give me a break, man. Stoke City had possession of the ball. I got the ball back from them. Jeepers, man.
Made good contact there with the header, and on the ball goes Daniel Vass. That has gone out of play with the deflection. Mohamed Diame. Excellent positioning, and the interception is made. Fabian Delph. Gets his foot in there. Jelovic. Gaston Ramirez. Sanchez. Beautifully done, the back heel. Well done. Daniel Vass. Referee's pointed for a free kick here.
Holy hell, man. Damn. Come on.
He's still got a lot to do. He's in the box, but, well, didn't he do it well?
Son of a bitch.
Can't ask for much more than that.
And the scoreline is 2-1.
What the hell you think you're dealing with?
Can he turn away from the challenge here? Kozak.
God, another one? It's the back of the net, baby. That's your Tigers.
The keeper's pulled off a really good save, but that's when he needs the help of his defenders.
Good look here again by the replay of the goal.
You're going to shred them. to celebrate on my Hull City Tigers.
And the scoreline is 3-1.
Gave up a sloppy goal.
Scott Sinclair. David Myler. Jelovic. Keeping the ball moving. And hits it. Still in play here.
Son of a bitch.
Sinclair. Chance for the cross. And a sharp restart. If he wants support, he certainly...
Come on!
Close range shot. Got to be. He might be needed a... Will be a free kick. The stage is yours, Alan. Ramirez's goal.
Yeah, really nice strike. He had a little glance up, saw the keeper's position and found the gap to his left.
Michael Dawson. Mohamed Diame. It's his speciality, isn't it? The back heel like that. Comes up more often than not. This is the chance. Got to me.
Looking to and trying to call off the Wolves. I'm ripping them to shreds, baby. Trying to call off the Wolves. He's all gutted. I've been chewing on his guts all day. I don't call off the Wolves. I rip their throats out.
But this match is becoming rather one-sided. Carlos Sanchez.
I'll never call off the Wolves.
Scott Sinclair.
They won't call off the Wolves on me.
No delay here. That's a fine tackle. Jelovic. Undoya.
Shit.
The goalkeeper's ball now. Mohamed Diame. David Myler. This could be a chance. Too eager, too
Fuck.
Early offside.
Sorry about that. Did I ever call off the dogs?
Jelovic. Excellent positioning, and the interception is made. David Myler. Here's the shot. Well, that was the shot. Not a bad effort.
No, not bad, but under the circumstances for a player of this level, you would hope that he can work the keeper there.
I tried, man. I really did. I really did.
Sinclair. Kozak. Good challenge here. Fabian Dell. Brady. He might be through. Well, he has a go. Strong hands from the goalkeeper to keep out a shot of that power. Looking to take the corner quickly.
Doing it all over, go off the dogs. Until you're in their dog chow. Dig over, call off the dogs.
Away, didn't they? I mean, it's been so poor from them, but you've got to applaud the winning team. Everything they've done's come off.
So we reach half time with a score.
You think I'll ever call off the dogs?
Let's take a look at the highlights from that first half, and then we'll get straight back to the commentators for the rest of the contest.
Think I'll ever call off the dogs? We never call them off.
Why did this thing just keep showing? Never mind. You know, I'm not even bothering. It's just ridiculous. Okay, round the league. Burnley over Manchester United 1-0. Arsenal, the Gunners, are leading Leicester City at Leicester City 2-1. Manchester City and Stoke City all tied at 1. Newcastle and Crystal Palace, with Newcastle leading at home 1-0. QPR and Sunderland all even, as well as Swansea, West Brom, and West Ham and Southampton all at 1 apiece. So, taking a look at the stats from that half, you can see your Hull City Tigers with 19 hard shots on goal, equating to 4 goals. A little bit better with the offsides and 4 corner kicks. Okay. Let's carry on.
Away we go for the second half. It was a very one-sided first half, as the scoreline tells us.
Think I'll ever call off the dogs.
Daniel Vaz. Well, it's a long, hard road to get back in this, but they are giving it a go.
You think I'll ever call off the dogs?
Mohamed Diame. That's very well read. And that's a very good interception. Jelovic.
Why didn't he call offsides there? You son of a bitches.
Jelovic. Really looking to make the losing team suffer with an increase of their advantage now.
God darn it.
You think I'll ever call off the dogs?
Have a look at what's coming up on your screens on EA Sports.
the English League Cup fixture, Aston Villa, they'll be hosting Newcastle United.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to...
Drink over, call off the dogs!
Well, they've got the ball there and they want to restart the game. You can understand that with the throw on it goes.
Darn it! Pass.
That will be a goal kick.
Oh, my gosh!
Well, the goal not given, Alan, and we can see why now.
Yeah, and as we all know, Martin, the whole of the ball has got to cross the line and it clearly doesn't. No, they've got to rule that one out. Not quite over the line.
Daniel Vaz. Benteke. And then he went, just diverted it away. Jelovic. He's got space. Here's the chance. Aren't resting on their laurels.
Still have a call of the dogs.
Mohamed Diame. Now here's a chance to get forward quickly. That will...
Bloody hell.
See, it clearly has done. Ali Sissoko. Kozak. Benteke. And a cross can come in. And he's given the free kick. Tried to play the advantage, couldn't see one in the end, and I think he was right. Trying to get themselves back into the game. Credit for that, but not for their shooting. I can't see this too many times, this goal. Jelovic. Gaston Ramirez. Tries his luck. He's reached it and he's caught it with a save. Brilliant. Mohamed Diame makes a challenge here. He's away easily past his man. Well, that's persistent play. Tenacious play from the defender. A goal today. Early in his career, of course, with this new club. Good feeling for him.
Yeah, it was. He took the goal well, and he's apart from the goal, he's played well. His general game has been very tidy.
Mohamed Diame. That's another one given away below his normal standards. Shots on here. Great hands. Got a yellow card here for their player.
Well, it was avoidable, but he jumped in.
Libor Kozak.
Sliding in and taking his part in the game into a dangerous territory, really.
Yeah, he might have done a bit more damage to his opponent than seems to have been the case.
Come on.
David Myler. Has done very well to clear that. Mohamed Diame. And that's being judged by the officials as offside. Look, clear enough.
Oh, my. Well, if I'm not flying, then I'm laying down.
Brady. David Myler. Mohamed Diame.
Come on. Damn it.
Well, that could be a throw. The opponent read the direction of the throw. Carlos Sanchez.
Oh, really nice footwork, but look at the defending.
And here's the cross. Fabian Delph. Sanchez. And they've got the ball back through a very good interception. It's meant to be some Villa giving away the free kick. It's their foul. It is going to be a change in midfield. A good performer is going to just have a rest for the last few minutes.
Yeah, he plays with his head as well as his legs, because you don't always have to run about too much. Positionally, he was top class today.
Change is going to be made. The central midfield player has had a good day. He's going to be replaced for the closing minutes of the game.
Yeah, this lad's got a confidence, sometimes cockiness about him. He's really commanding on his day, and this was certainly his day.
David Myler. Hull City's next game.
Yeah, they're playing West Ham United in their next match in the Capital One Cup.
Brilliant opening, got to be. Too eager, too early, offside.
I've got to have those cups. I've got to have all the silverware.
To try it, really. At this part of the pitch, it's okay. They need to try and get the ball back now. Stephen Quinn. David Myler. Sanchez. It's a return ball. And that has gone out of play with the deflection. Carlos Sanchez. Bielovic. This could be a chance. Really in the clear now. And the shot's off. That's a decent save by the goalkeeper. Sissoko. Stephen Quinn. He's trying the back heel again and it's worked. Carlos Sanchez. Enjoy it. David David Myler. And his team now can move away from their defensive areas. Gaston Ramirez. Stephen Quinn. How frustrating is this for the other team trying to get the touch of the ball? Jelovic, that's very well read, and that's a very good interception. Quinn. And the whistle is gone because the assistant flagged for offside.
You do have to take a chance when you play that kind of game, but they're confident in the way that they're regimented at the back.
David Myler. Good control here. Quite congested midfield, but good passing from this team. Jelovic. Stephen Quinn. Yeah, he's come too early. He's offside. Kozak. Scott Sinclair. Just a touch, enough to take it over the line. Gaston Ramirez. Jelovic. Quick. The offside is given. Gaston Ramirez. Sanchez. Now the possibility for a cross. Corner for Aston Villa.
Yes! It's your Hull City Tigers, baby! Put it away! You know it. The man of the hour.
A goal from Jelovic. And he simply struck that one home, giving the keeper no chance.
It's too strong for him. Fool trying to do everything to stop me. Oh yeah. Woo! Try to give him the golden boot this year. But it's still early. It's still way early. I gotta keep my concentration.
Past his man, and he has got a chance to get the cross in. We'll do it. Jelovic. Another successful challenge. Stephen Quinn. At the outset, you might have thought Hull City would be pleased just to be in the game at this stage. As it is, they're dominating the game. Historic result for them on the cards. Well, the game went on, but I think we're going to go back to that earlier incident and a booking for the player. The referee did play the advantage, which was good to see.
That's a little late.
See the ref had spotted the incident, and he wasn't going to let him get away with it.
Very much a game that has gone one way, and one-way traffic was not. I certainly did a lot of preparation thinking this would be tight, checking out drawn games between these two teams, and it's all irrelevant now. It's very one-sided.
Well, there have been a lot of mistakes, haven't there, from the losing team defensively, and they've just not turned up so far.
Maybe the cross. Oh, it's out of play, off the player. It's a poor throw and well intercepted. Sanchez. Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free. Throw in here. No, he's thrown it straight to an opponent. 5-2, remind you the score. What does it mean for the next game, Alan?
Yeah, Aston Villa go up against Newcastle United after this, and I think there'll be a few words spoken in the dressing room afterwards because they've been miserable out there.
Undoye. Throw in now. Well, that's what substitutes are for, to be used. We've got one.
All right, let's get our man Jelovic out of there. Maybe. Let's see. He still seems to be pretty fresh. Let's get Gaston out of there. Okay. All right. All right, let's go.
Coming on now.
Probably should have changed the formation. I'm still in this attacking formation.
Aloft is the goal-scoring midfielder.
Well, he's getting a good clap, and the fans here love him because he always puts in 100% effort.
All right, let's keep our head in the game. It's not over yet.
Sanchez. Here, challenge. Good one. David Myler. And that will be a throw. Stephen Quinn.
Oh, wrong way.
Well, that's a throw.
Darn it.
Teke.
They could just continue. I had the advantage.
The big tattoo is massive.
Well, there's no doubt, and there has been no doubt for some time about who was going to win this game. In quickly, and hits it. Oh, well saved. At least he's playing to full potential today.
Yeah, well, he's got pride to think about, and he doesn't want to get beaten, does he, even though his team are losing.
Jelovic. It's quick. He's got that and cleared the ball away and saved his side from a difficult situation. Well, he did well to try it, really. If this part of the pitch is okay. And the shot's on. He's blocked it. He's kept it out.
Darn it.
Their corner.
Ah! Oh.
Here's a shot off target.
Just over the bar, man. Just over the bar.
Now, long balls into the box from any angle. It's all about trying to win that first header.
And that will go to the goalkeeper here. Benteke. Good save by the goalkeeper, and he makes sure he keeps the ball. Daniel Vaz, Ali Sissoko. They've set it up well for the cross, and the cross comes in now.
That was a handball.
Side call just at the moment where they thought they were going to be in to score.
Yeah, and when you've got some pacey strikers like this side have, sometimes it can look a long way offside. I mean, he's got it right in the end, and we've got the chance to watch it on replays 3 or 4 times, but fair play to him.
Cleverly. Enjoy it.
Oh!
Stephen Quinn.
There's the full time.
Whistle blows, final whistle. Hull City get the victory that they wanted.
Woo!
The other team have been put out of their misery here because they were very much off the pace today in a one-sided contest.
Well, it's totally humiliating, wasn't it? I'm sure they're willing for the ref to blow the final whistle.
Well, there was only really one team in that game, and the away fans will be travelling home delighted with their big win. I'll leave you with the full match highlights, and until next time, I've been Jeff Stelling.
Good night. It was all whole city, baby. Maybe not so much as that.
Oh, it's an offside decision.
I think I had two goals that were nullified by offsides. That one was very close. That was very close. Golly.
Yelenic!
Ha ha! You can't hear the highlights. The crowd is booing so much. Well, we're going to end it. That goaltender made a hell of a lot of saves. And that's the back of the net for Gaston Ramirez. Woo! That's still booing. Oh, let's just go on and put them out of their misery. Okay, let's take a look at the facts of your Hull City Tigers. 34 shots on goal versus six from Aston Villa. They had 3 on target, 2 went in. We had 25 on target, and 5 of them went in. So as you can see, well, I reduced the number of offsides to 8 in the second half. All right. So going to the player ratings, Nika Jokovic with an insane 9.6 rating. Diame Ndoye with a 9.3. All the rest of the players played well, including Mr. Diame with an 8.8 and Gaston Ramirez with a 9.5. And not so much for Aston Villa, except for the goaltender. 9.4 for him. I guess so. Okay, so that's your Hull City Tigers. Go ahead and advance it. So it was Burnley 2. Whoa. Fans. Transfer deadline. Total spent today.
The Barclays Premier League. Aston Villa 2. Hull City 5. Burnley 2. Manchester United 0. Leicester City 2. Arsenal 3. Manchester City 1. Stoke City 1. Newcastle United 2. Crystal Palace 1. Queen's Park Rangers 1, Sunderland 1, Swansea City 1, West Bromwich Albion 2, West Ham United 2, Southampton 2. So what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table, we have new leaders in Newcastle United with 9 points. In second, Chelsea with 6 points. In third, Hull City with 6 points.
Go ahead, baby!
In fourth, Sunderland with 5 points. In fifth, West Ham United with 5 points. In sixth, Queen's Park Rangers with 4 points.
We will be
in
turning
seventh,
the favorites,
Burnley
you know.
With 4 points. In eighth, Crystal Palace with 4 points. Bottom of the table, Leicester City with no points. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Aston Villa with 1 point. Third bottom, Swansea City with 1 point. Fourth bottom, West Bromwich Albion with 3 points. Fifth bottom, Tottenham Hotspur with 3 points.
Let's take a look at the news. Great start from Alcavian. In this early season game, Hull City was victorious 5-2 over Aston Villa in a league clash. Most pundits felt that the results were fair given the balance of play. Also making a debut last match was Mohamed Diame, who played quite well. Third match in for new Hull City boss Eric Malkavian, and the victory sees them bag a crucial 3 points in their quest to move up the league. One swallow doesn't make a summer, said I, said this Malkavian. Just as this one victory doesn't make our season. It's a starting point, though, and those 3 points could well prove crucial at the end of the season. Whoops. Best signing this club has made in years, stated one elated fan after they were asked about the manager's current form. It's great to see people happy with the way the club is progressing. Since joining the Hull City, I've hit the ground running. I hope this keeps on going. Okay, I'm not sure. I'm trying to figure out. I'll just use the mouse. Toward Manchester, Malkavian, which sets a great start to his reign. Fans will surely be eager to see more outstanding performance and fixtures ahead. All right. Taking a look at this. Justin Connor coming up in this round of games. Aston Villa hosts Hull City. Both teams will be looking to take the points. Use the match as a springboard to get their assault on the upper reaches of the table well and truly on the way. All right. Last game, so fans will be eager to see things pan out in the third match. With many fans describing the manager's team selection as crowd-pleasing, the boss will surely be keeping an eye out opposition attacking form, ensuring they can deal with them effectively. All right. So that's club news, our news. Let's go to the office. We'll be back to take a look at that in the next episode, though. I want to thank you for watching. I'm Eric Malkavian, and this has been your Hull City Tigers with the victory 5-2 over Aston Villa on the road. Thank you for watching. You have a great evening. Goodbye.